and welcome to God's View. We're so glad you joined us. Oh, you know, us girls were just talking prior to this program today of how grateful we are for when we get the prayer calls. And these are the things that you're saying to me, that you girls seem so authentic and, no, not seem, you said you are, and love gushes from you. And we've heard so many things. And I will tell you this. It doesn't swell our head because we know it's not us, it's Jesus in us. But one thing that's so wonderful about that, it makes us know, girls, don't it? Makes all of us know that what we're doing, that we are so grateful to be a part of it, and that it's fruit from what we're doing, isn't it? That's everything to us. If we know that that is what's happening, when we come into this, your home, and you call and you say those things and how grateful you are and how much hope it brought you that day, oh my gosh, we are so blessed by that.
And it's all
And it's all Jesus.
Just thank Him.
Thank Him, yes. Amen. And thank you for watching and continue to tell your friends about us. And you know what? As we have this shot, why don't I just, for you new viewers, thank you for joining us. Yeah. Change the channel. You will be so blessed because the Holy Spirit moves mightily through us, and we don't say that tacky or proud. We just know that we surrender to Him, obey, and He comes in and rocks people's worlds, and we're just thankful to be a part of it. So I am Charlene back to Marion, one of your hosts. I can't even say my last name, but it touches me when I talk about what God's doing, and I get almost tongue-tied because it's so, I'm so grateful. I really am. But this is Lana Gardner, one of your other hosts, and this is Jennifer Griffin, and we have Lana Peluso. I mean, Marianne.
I really don't know
what's the matter with me today. Lana Peluso.
Hey, I like that.
I like that.
Is that like Lana Gardner? I'll take it. Lana Gardner Peluso.
They're great names. Lana. She's like a movie star.
Yeah.
Well, anyways.
Lassie.
I'm so glad you joined us. All of us girls are. We welcome you. And like I said, you're just going to be really, really blessed today because we're going to be talking about the love of God. And oh my gosh, I think about the love of God. How did it all start? For God so loved the world, you and I in the world, that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him should not perish but have everlasting life.
Yep.
Right there. Mm-hmm. Right there, girls, it would be. It would be enough. I mean, He sent Him because He loved us, and thank God I was such a wreck. I was a train wreck. And each day, I mean, you know, I'll even look back 10 or 15 years old and I think, oh my God, I was so bad then. I was so, you know, I mean, even though I was in the Lord, you know, because of things, how you grow and you grow.
From glory to glory.
You say something that you've done or whatever. Yes. But the love of God was always there to say, you know what, Charlene, look where you were.
Yeah.
Look where you were. I love you and I'm going to keep taking you to the next place. Yes. Love it.
Amen.
Oh. So what do y'all got?
Everybody talk at one time.
Okay, well let me give this scripture then. Romans 8:35. I was thinking of this and I jotted it down on my paper because who shall ever separate us from Christ's love? Woohoo! Suffering or affliction and tribulation or calamity or distress or persecution or hunger or destitution or peril or sword? Even as it is written, for that sake we are put to death all day long. We are regarded and counted as sheep for the slaughter. Yet amid all these things, we are more than conquerors and gain a surpassing victory through Him who loved us. For I am persuaded, I love this scripture, we're in Romans 8 and started in verse 35 and going through 39. That I am sure, I do not doubt, that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor things impending and threatening for things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate you, us, all of us, from the love of God, which is in what? Christ Jesus, our Lord.
Amen.
Oh, that gives me chills.
Yeah, I know.
I'm just goosebumped all over.
He has a solution to every problem. There's nothing too difficult for Him.
Nothing.
He's the God that parted the Red Sea.
Yes.
And we give Him our sin And he gives us eternal life.
Oh, gosh.
What an exchange.
How can you, what an exchange?
What a deal.
Oh, please, yeah, deal, deal of the...
Such a deal.
Ever, forever. Yeah, eternity. Deal of eternity.
The
we
deal?
Ought to, we
oh,
do, we ought to do a show on that.
Deal of eternity.
You thought of the same thing that I did.
That'd
be a great show. Deal of the eternity.
Yeah, right. The wheel. Yeah, and all the deals that are on the wheel that God has given us.
Yes.
And
that's
we cool. win. Yeah.
Yes.
We
yes.
always win.
Yes. You want to talk about that show, Let's Make a Deal, okay. or Wheel of Fortune.
Yeah,
we got
exactly.
the wheel. Got the real deal.
This is the fortune.
Yeah, this is the fortune. Jesus.
I was on that show. I won an iron.
Really? Are you kidding me?
I won
me?
An iron.
When were you on that show?
About 100.
Oh, that is so funny. And you know, you guys, I want to bring up that scripture too, since we're talking about love, because it's very important that God gave us a spirit of love. When he said God so loved the world, and that's why he did anything, because he loved the world and he gave, we all should be givers.
Amen.
You know, let's put that in there. But one of the biggest scriptures that I've always loved is in 1 Timothy, you gals. Where is it? I mean, I thought I wrote it
about
down, but I didn't.
What?
Where it says, I did not give you a spirit of fear.
1 Timothy 1:7.
Okay, but of love and
first
of power and of sound mind. The first thing, what did he give us? His spirit
love.
And it's a spirit of adoption. Right. It's a spirit of victory. Mm-hmm. It's love conquers. Because when he says in 1 Corinthians 13, the love chapter, love is never boastful. Love is always kind. I mean, because that's what
others.
He is.
Mm-hmm.
And so if he's that and he's all the fruit of the spirit in Galatians 5:22, then we're all that. We got all
that's
that love,
right.
that kindness, that peace. That's who he is.
Yeah.
That's his character. And so when we're bad, it's just like, he's good because that's his character. He doesn't have this mean character where he says, oh, you were so unlovely, I'm going to be unlovely. He just doesn't do that. He loves. He's the God of love. And you know, this was your topic today.
Oh,
the love
yeah.
of God, remember?
I know.
Yes.
Well, you know, I know you're all waiting for the Song of Solomon, but I thought I'd fool you and give you Isaiah 26.
Oh, okay. Oh. Well, let's.
Which says, I give you perfect peace, whose mind is
stayed
on me. Perfect peace.
I love that.
That's something that we crave. We've been made for perfect peace. If we're not allowed as Christians to get into stress or worry, that we could take all of our worries and all of our cares and have victory over them. And that, and then we call on him, and in a moment, he's there.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. He's there. But we have to call on him. So many times, we're hit by Satan. We have all of this stress and worry and so forth, and we wring our hands, and we're afraid, and, oh, God, you got to help me. Instead of saying, God, I'm not going to get upset. This is your problem.
Yes.
I'm putting it in your lap because I can't take care of it.
Yes.
But you can.
Cast my cares
it's
upon,
no problem
cast
for
your
you.
Cares upon him, for he cares for you and for him.
Amen.
Yeah.
Yes.
I mean, that's true.
Well,
you know what? I love Ephesians. Ephesians 3:14-20.
Oh, that's your scripture.
No, that's okay. We were thinking the same thought.
Is that right? I just love that. Paul talks about appreciating, you know, what God has done for us through Jesus. But I love the 17th verse of Ephesians 3:17. This is it. That Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, that you, being rooted and grounded in love.
Amen.
In what love? Being rooted and grounded in my love for God? No, he says, we're to be rooted and grounded in God's love for us. Our love for God, my love for God goes up and down. You know, depending on the circumstances, I waver, and when I remain faithless, he is faithful. But, you know, like you said, Lana, if we are going to be able to trust him, we're going to have to be rooted in his love for us, not our love for him. Our love goes up and down, being rooted and grounded in his love.
Yes,
I love that.
Yeah.
That's how you stay rooted and grounded. That's how you cast your cares. That's how you make him your shelter. That's how you trust him, knowing that it doesn't come from you. It's not based on our works. It's based on
His love being rooted and grounded. Yes. I love that.
You were talking about calm and you were talking about peace. And doesn't he say even perfect love cast out all fear? Mm-hmm. And when we get no peace, we're in some kind of doubt or unbelief or fear.
Open the door to Satan.
Yes. Yeah. And so it and everything, if we know the love of God, it takes care of everything. And listen, you know, all of us need a greater revelation of the love of God, because each day we still want to get into works when we think we've done something wrong or bad, or God may be disappointed, or, you know, people, seems so easy for the flesh to shift there, and you got to think, oh no, God loves me.
Yeah, that's
God
right.
Loves
that's
me.
Where we need to be rooted and grounded.
Yeah, God
you
loves
know, when
me.
You're grounded in something, you may float away because we're still in the flesh, but you stay grounded, you stay rooted.
Yes.
You don't let yourself get caught up in that pity part. Or that fear, or that worry. That's not to say you won't get hit with that walking through life. We will, because we live in a fallen world. But you resist it because you know it's not about you. It's about God's love.
Yeah.
That's just so exciting.
And I think it's so important to
problem.
Yeah, it's so important to experience that. And it talks about that in Ephesians. You're reading 17, and there's 18 and 19. It talks about experience and his love. And actually, let me read this. It says that you may really come to know practically through experience for yourself the love of Christ, which so far surpasses mere knowledge without experience, that you may be filled throughout your being unto all the fullness of God, may have the richest measure of the divine presence, and become a body wholly filled and flooded with God himself.
Mm.
And to me, that's huge, so because a lot of times we practically know things in our head. We know things, but it needs to come into here. And that relationship with him, it gives us an experience. And, you know, we know that God's not mad at us if we're understand his love. He's not mad at us. We make mistakes. Mm-hmm. We turn to him, we say we're sorry, and he immediately takes us back. He immediately embraces us and loves us. It's not a wedge between us. But you know, a lot of times if you've grown up in different religions that would, like I did, and I thought, well, God was mad at me all the time. I had to, you know, and I didn't know how that would happen. But, you know, by experiencing him, by knowing his goodness, just really experience, and that's what we want, is that experience with him. Like that, and it floods us. And you know, for me, that changed my life. I learned how to, you know, hear from God in a way of writing things down, and I would write. He would write me back, and I would hear how much he loved me, how much he loved me, how much he loved me. That was the biggest thing, and that changed my life. And so
journaling's
huge.
You go back
dialoguing,
and think, oh my gosh,
I would weep and cry, and I would. He loves me. He's not mad at me. Oh wow, that was revelation. And I think people think God's mad at them, and they need to know that he loves you no matter where you're at. It doesn't matter where you're at.
I love God, and I love that he loves us, and I love that outfit. You look darling.
I love darling.
I don't know.
Oh,
really, that was really a powerful role, but I mean, I just, it's so cute. You look so darn, you look so
you're
darn
the only person I know
today.
We can talk about something. And we
I know,
to the
I do a shift to the journey. Like that. So, but you know what? God's a fun God. You know, some people get so holy and we go, oh my gosh, how could you say that in the mirror? But you know what? Because God is good. You know,
he's
one
fun.
Thing is a big, big deal. When you are not experiencing the love of God, seriously, this is a big deal. You have to put off the spirit of heaviness. I put off the spirit of heaviness and curse its fruits of rejection, gluttony, oppression, depression. I mean, there's so much stuff that comes with that. And then you just put on the fruit of the Spirit. And when you put on the fruit of the Spirit, then you're putting on God, like in Galatians 5:22, love, joy, peace, gentleness, kindness, meekness, self-control, long-suffering, gentleness. I mean, against such, he says, there's no law. And so sometimes you just have to, you know, just speak some things and take some things off and put him on, you know. No, because it's not like you're putting it on. Of course, it comes from within, but it's in you, through you. And when you start, you know, really thinking of who God is and his character, and he is love.
Yeah.
He's love. So that means if he is love, he's not a hater. You know, a lot
That's
of people,
right.
you know, a lot of the young people say, now don't be a hater. Don't be being a hater. You know, that's what the young kids say now. Well, you know what? It's true. And God is not a hater.
Yeah.
You could be in a prison cell right now, which we've gotten letters from. You could be out on the streets, which we've had a few prostitutes. Yeah. Matter of fact, I even met with one. And you know what? Once you know the love of God, that it doesn't matter, it'll go as, I mean, I'm telling you, what does it say where it's, even though my spirit go, in Psalms 139,
make my depth in hell.
There he be, yeah. And so the thing is, you know, he loves you.
Yeah.
If you're out there prostituting, if you're out there ganging it, if you're out there anything, God has you listening to my voice right now to say, I love you. I love you. Doesn't matter what you've done. Just come to me. Let's start right now. Don't say, oh, I got to clean up. Well, if I walked into a church, the walls would fall in. Or I'm not saying you have to run to the church. I'm saying run to Jesus.
Amen.
All you got to do is say, Jesus. Mm-hmm. Jesus. Call on his name. And we're going to lead you to him in just a little while. But those of you who don't know, so stay tuned. Don't change the channel.
Sees no blemish in us.
Yeah.
We see our immaturity.
Yes.
We see our weakness. But he doesn't see that.
He doesn't, yeah.
Once we made Jesus the Lord of our lives, mm-hmm. he sees the finished product.
Yeah, I like that.
He looks at us,
yes.
he sees Jesus.
Yes.
And yes, do we sin? Yeah. Do we blow it? Yeah. But he doesn't see that.
Yeah.
Because his goal, he's got a goal with us to take us.
Yes.
Far beyond the cross.
And it's up to us to walk with him and let him do that and not allow those things to bring us down. That he has a work, he's doing a work in us, and you need to be patient with yourself today. When you started out, I love that. Paul said, I'm persuaded that neither death. Are you persuaded today?
Are you persuaded?
Yeah. Are you looking for something in yourself to be consistent or good? If you are, you will fail every time. And it's a setup.
Yeah.
It's a setup. And that's pride. You know, you can have pride and not realize it because you just want to be good for God and you want to do the right thing. Well, sometimes the Lord has to allow us. Mm-hmm. He takes down a hedge. He'll take his presence away to show us what we really are when we're all alone without his love and his grace.
Mm-hmm.
So he doesn't want you to prove anything today. He wants you to be persuaded. Let him prove to you his love. Our job is to be persuaded. I'm persuaded. Yeah. Are you? We're persuaded.
Yeah.
Are you persuaded today? When the devil hits you, when fear hits you, when worry hits you, when condemnation hits you, have you come to the point in your life where you say, you know what? God, I know you love me, and it's not based on anything I can or can't do. It's about what you've done. He wants you to be rooted and grounded. And so many people, girls, so many people today, they get a little head knowledge of the word, and they think, okay, I've arrived. I've got it. I'm there. And God, he's taken us back to basics.
Yes,
that it's all about his
good.
Love
that
and
was
nothing
so good.
About us.
Well, I wasn't laughing at what you were saying, but...
I was thinking, do I need to wipe something?
No, that was so... No, but anyways, we were getting tickled because the shot wasn't on us, so we thought we could be funny.
Okay.
Yeah. We were being silly behind. But he becomes our magnificent obsession, doesn't he?
Amen.
We are obsessed with the love of God.
I am obsessed with him.
And that's why you get to the point where television and entertainment and going to movies, there's nothing that can compare. Once you taste and see, you spend time with him, all the great husbands, lovers, friends, children, nothing compares to his love. Let him love you because he's standing with his arms open wide, just waiting for you to get in his word, to spend time with him, to listen for his voice, and then for you to be living with the obsession of God.
And I think you mentioned something really important, you know, because I really believe that pride can get in the way of love, because it does. What happened with Lucifer? He had pride, and he fell. And so I feel like, you know, a lot. I mean, I don't feel like I know that pride will come in, and you're not going to walk in that love. You're not going to live in that love that you need to live in. So, you know, continue to be teachable, continue to receive from other people,
yes.
receive from God, because a lot, like you said, if you think you know you have it all, then there's areas that the enemy is really ripping you off in, and it's yeah. and it's gonna it says those who, you know, it probably comes before a fall. And so I'm just saying that it's a warning, really, because yeah. all of us can fall into pride yes. in areas. None of us are exempt of that. And so mm-hmm. we got to continually check
good.
Our hearts.
Good,
check
yeah.
our hearts.
Mary Ann and I were talking when we were driving up here, and we were talking about the fact that, you know, we're at the point that every time we have a worry or care, we give it to Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes these are very serious.
Yeah.
But we don't worry about them anymore, because
right.
once we give them to the Lord,
mm-hmm.
see, if you hold on to your worries and cares, mm-hmm. if you hold them, then God's saying, well, mm-hmm. she's not giving it to me, he's
yeah.
not giving it to me, then yeah. it's his problem.
Yeah.
It's her problem.
Yeah. Yeah.
But once you say, God, you know, this is too difficult for me. I can't, I don't know how to surmount this, but I know you do. So here it is, that it's almost embarrassing, because you don't feel that stress anymore.
And that's so yes. nice.
You don't feel,
exactly.
oh my gosh, shouldn't I be worried about
exactly.
this? I'm not worried about this anymore, because it's in God's hands.
That's
and,
right.
And mm-hmm. I don't know how or when he's going to do it. I only know for sure it's going to get taken
yeah.
care of.
Yeah.
It's better and better than anything yes. we could do. Mm-hmm.
Exactly. And isn't that just, to me, it's a Geiger counter. When I get into doubt, that shows me that I'm not trusting God.
Yes.
I'm looking to me. Mm. And I'm so glad that he lets these things come up in our lives, not to put us down or judge us or condemn us. You got to recognize yeah. that he's trying to show you need to trust me more. You need to know that I love you. You need to get out of a workspace mentality. You need to know that I'm there for you. And anything, you know, like you said, we were talking on the way up, if you allow that doubt, that fear, that worry to be planted in the soil of distrust, that thing will grow. So we're not saying that, you know, it doesn't happen. Mm-hmm. What we're saying is the minute it hits us, we let it go, else it'll grow. Let mm-hmm. it go so
yeah.
it doesn't
yeah.
grow.
That's
even
good.
Through adversity.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter.
You keep it, you water
exactly.
it.
Exactly. Don't let
and
it grow.
And it turns into anxiety and panic attacks.
Yes.
And
yeah.
See, those things.
Every
single
mm-hmm.
Yes,
that
that's
yeah.
it. Someone, you know, you're out there
good
today
show.
And you're just
this is a good topic.
You're wondering, how did I get to this place? I used to love God. I used to be able to trust him. It's because you didn't let it go and it began
grew.
To grow.
Yeah.
And
so.
He sees no blemish in us.
Yes.
He sees, it's so magnificent mm-hmm. to feel so loved that it doesn't matter. You know, I remember someone was really rude to me and was putting me down. I said, you know something?
Oh, I wish I was
there. I don't care what you think. Yeah, I don't care what you think.
Me too.
Jesus is crazy about me.
Yes, we would have beat him up for you. We would have laid hands on him in Jesus' name.
Yes. You poor thing, you tormented
yes.
thing. You're picking on God's anointed. You better watch out. Because
uh-huh.
he fights our battles, doesn't
that's
he?
Right.
That's
right.
That's the love of God.
Well, mm-hmm. and I like what you say about, you know, he sees the end result.
Yes.
Because we can't even see the end result. That's why when there's prophetic words and different things like that come forth, it's the yeah. end. It's what God sees for the future for us.
Yes.
And so
right.
those things are so powerful. They actually, they what is it, spring us forth to that,
yes.
that area. And that's why the prophetic
yes.
word, when you get a prophetic word that's from
us.
The Lord, it
yeah.
launches us. That's
yeah.
the word.
Right.
But because God already sees you in a different place where you're at. And so sometimes we get stuck and mm. we just need a little bit.
Well, Father God seen the beginning,
mm-hmm.
mm-hmm. from the beginning, he seen the end.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus, when he came, he already knew it. He sees the ending from the beginning.
Yeah,
exactly.
And so it's just, you know, it's so cool to just really.
Well, you know what
love
it is?
God.
It's like a parade. Okay,
yeah.
we're sitting here, we're looking at a parade, and we see the lions and the tigers and the
mm-hmm.
marionettes and all of the little dancers and acrobats and so forth. But God looks at the parade. He sees the beginning
yes.
to
yes.
the end.
Yes. Yes.
And the wonderful thing about it is, if we turn those problems over to him, we can be assured that it's working together for good.
Good.
Yes.
Only good because
yes,
he's a good,
good
God.
That's right.
Because
mm-hmm.
that's all he is. He's a God of love. And that if you're being attacked, if there's negatives in your lives, it's not God. It's Satan himself.
Yes, because God loves us. God loves us. You know, and many people, I think, you know, we've all touched a little bit on how you always think you've done something, and then if you feel that way, and you let that grow, like you said, you water it, you let it grow instead of the love of God, if you don't let go or even stop looking at yourself like that. And what happens, and you start feeling like, okay, you let the enemy start saying to you, oh, I'm not blessed, I can't be blessed because I've done this and now God's not going to bless me. See, that's one of the biggest lies.
Yeah.
That is one of the biggest lies. And right here, I want to tell you God's word. I had just kind of looked down at it. And he's so good, he always just brings us to things. But in Galatians 6:9, and I love this scripture, and I did a study one time on this. It is so dynamic, but I have too long to teach. But it says, let us not lose heart and grow weary and faint in acting nobly and doing right. For in due time, at the appointed season, we will reap if we do not loosen and relax our courage and faint.
That's right.
Now, I'm saying that because of this. If you continue to sow that seed, do not faint. Do not faint on the love of God even. You know, I know a lot of people do this scripture for a lot of many things. You know, a lot they got all kinds of different revelations on that. But I'm just saying, do not let your heart grow weary or faint today. Mm-hmm. Jesus loves you. If you don't know him, we are all about, on this program, you going to heaven. Jesus came to seek and save the lost. He's seeking you today. If you've tuned in and you're, I hear so many people on the prayer lines. I was just flipping through the channel and there you were. And I asked God for a word. I just had a lady call the other day and said, I was just crying out to God. I was crying out to him. I need a word, God. I need a word or I need something. And she says, I'm a first time viewer. She says, and she said, your stuff just popped up on the internet.
Jesus.
And she got a word from the Lord and we were praying for her. But anyways, if you don't know him, just say, Jesus, forgive me of my sin. I really am a mess right now. I need to know this love of God. I need to know. He loved you so much, he died for you. And if you just say, forgive me, I believe you're the Son of God. I believe you died for me. I believe you rose again, and I believe you're coming back to get me. I tell you, you'll be in heaven eternity. I'm telling you, the devil's such a liar and a deceiver, and he's telling you that God don't love you and you'll never be right, but you will be. Call on his name today. And if you've done that, call 307-637-PRAY. That's 7729. That's 7729. But if you do the pray, and we'll send you a Bible. And always go to the bottom of the screen and look at the advertisement that's coming up right now. It just tells you how to get today's DVD or CD of the program. And we do need partners. Go to our website and press the donate button today or send it to the P.O. Box number at the bottom of the screen. We really need your help. And if you become a partner, you have to let us know and we'll send you the CD or the DVD of the month. We love you. God loves you more. We will see you next week.
Be blessed over and over again as the Holy Spirit ministers to your heart by ordering today's program on DVD or CD. DVD $9, CD $7. Both include shipping and handling. Order your copy today at www.